Hey, welcome to Gaming Bench. Here today with the Intel ARC B580 unboxing. This card is from ASRock. It's their Steel Legend graphics card, which if you don't know, that's their white graphics card. And those are popular among a certain market segment. You know, we've seen black graphics cards and gray and other colors for many years. White has become popular. We're getting white cases, white power supplies, even white motherboards. White motherboards are kind of a rarity, but they do exist now and then. Anyway, ARC B580. This is their mid-tier product, so by the name, it takes over from the A580, you would assume. Priced at $249 MSRP. So that's not too bad. It's got a special note thing, ASRock manual. There's nothing really that's gonna be in there that's interesting. Let's get ahead to the card itself. Triple fan cooler, obviously. You can see that immediately. Rest in there nicely. Go ahead, come around here for the unwrapping. There's not too much to see, I don't think, because graphics cards all tend to look a lot alike. There is wrapping on it, the shrink wrap. So we gotta take that off at some point. Let's see if I can grab that. ASMR, here you go. Possibly some covers on the fans. I'll have to see about that, about this here. Anyway, there you go, graphics card. Actually, there is one thing that you do need to look at, because this is going to be interesting to see. Oh, check that out. We got dual 8-pin power connectors. Now, the base model, the reference card that Intel is shipping out, is supposed to have a single 8-pin power connector and a 190 watt TBP, total board power, or TGP, total graphics power, whatever you want to call it. This one has two 8-pin slots, possibly for overclocking purposes. It's probably factory overclocked, but we'll see. I don't have specs on this particular model. You can actually hook up, you can see here there's a ARGB header, maybe you can't read that, ARGB header with an LED on off switch. So besides the card's RGB lighting itself, if you plug in other lights to the ARGB header, you got a single switch that can turn it all on or off. I'm not sure how useful that is to most people, but if you're into RGB lighting, that is probably helpful. Ports, we have 1, 2, 3 display port. I believe these are supposed to be display port 2.1, 13.5 gigabits per second per lane. So UHBR 13.5, meaning 54 gigabits per second total. That is not the maximum display port 2.1 supports. It's higher than the UHBR 10 that was supported on ARC A series. Alchemist GPUs. So things have been bumped a little bit. That matches AMD's DisplayPort 2.1 on the RX 7000 series RDNA 3. And then there's a single HDMI 2.1 port. The HDMI, 48 gigabits per second total throughput, but some of that goes to overhead, so it's actually 42 gigabits per second of data. I believe DisplayPort 2.1 UHBR 13.5, so 54 gigabits per second. It's higher than that. I think it's 52.7 gigabits per second for data. It's something like that. It uses 128B/132B encoding. So for every 128 bits you want to send, it uses 132, whereas the HDMI port is, oh shoot, it's like 1618B or 810B or something like that. Anyway, it's less efficient encoding on HDMI 2.1. So you only get 42 of the 48, whereas on DisplayPort 2.1, you get upwards of 50 of the 54. That's about it. I mean, fans, they all spin the same way, it looks like. Triple fan cooling. This shouldn't be like a super hot running card or loud running. So three fans should allow it to be cool and quiet. Official embargo launch date for the ARRock B580 is December 13th. They go on sale then, $249 for the base models. This one being white and gray with triple fan cooling, factory overclock, it's probably going to be a bit more expensive. I don't know exactly what the MSRP is right now. I think it might be $269 or $279. The card is designed to compete with NVIDIA's RTX 4060. That's kind of how Intel is billing it, which is sort of kind of like, okay, that's almost a two-year-old card, and it was a budget card. Well, not budget, it was mainstream, $300. And you're going to come in $50 below that with maybe 10% higher performance and higher power draw. And you're using TSMC's 5 nanometer N5 process, where NVIDIA used 4 nanometer 4NP, or yeah, 4NP, no, just 4N. And had a 120 watt TDP. So it's not all sunshine and roses, but the card looks like it should do decently. And you've got upgrades to the architecture and software, so XeSS2 with frame generation will be a thing. That just means one more frame generation and upscaling option that developers need to support. Hopefully they can tie all of those together so that FSR 3.1, DLSS3, and XeSS2 frame generation basically take the same inputs and we can get games that utilize all three. Not many of those right now. In fact, none of them, but there will be by launch, I think, at least one. That's it. Thanks for watching. Check back in a little over a week, and I hope to have up a full review of the Intel ARRock B580, courtesy of ASRock. Take care.